We just spent the last few days up here in Heaven's Landing in Northeast Georgia. Today, we're going to fly a brand new 206 down to Falcon Field down by Atlanta. Let's get this started.
Automated advisory, wind 050 at 5 knots, temperature 24 Celsius, 2.21 Celsius, altimeter 3031, density altitude 4,100. Welcome to the most wonderful flight and community on Earth.
Welcome aboard, everybody. Today we have an exciting flight for you. We have Sarah on board. Sarah, welcome
hey.
Aboard. And we have Captain Mindy in the back.
Hello.
We're here at Heaven's Landing, and we're going to be flying down to Falcon Field, IFR, in the 206. All right, we've got the airport information here. It was pretty unique. The runway is 5 and 23.
About 5,700 feet of runway.
Here to the right, and here to the left.
Clear and clear.
We had a great time up here. We did some golfing, and there's a lot of different activities you can do around this area. The city that's closest to Heaven's Landing here is Clayton, Georgia. If you haven't seen the video that we flew into here, we had a little golf competition. I'll be sure to link it up here in the top of the screen. You can check that out. We'll see who won between all of us in the first ever S1K Golf Classic. This airplane taxi is really nice. Handles really well on the ground. All right, we're gonna go right over here to the right, and we'll do a quick run up, and we'll catch you guys on the other side of this.
Is anyone base or final for runway 5? Heaven's Landing. Heaven's Landing traffic. Stationer taking off runway 5. We'll be making right traffic and departing down to the south. Heaven's Landing.
All right, sounds good. Nobody's in the area. We'll line up here on center line.
Yep.
You guys are going to have your mind blown when you see the scenery around this area once we take off. Coming in here was amazing. All right, we're all lined up. And takeoff power is set.
All right. So we're just looking for airspeed right now. Everything's fine. You're not going to overboost it. Airspeed, we're just 56 knots, and then we'll rotate. And here you are. We'll pull back, and she'll just want to take off and fly.
There you go.
And we're cruising.
I'm used to turboprops where you can't just jam the power up full forward. You know, you'd over-torque the engine.
Yeah, the nice thing about the Turbo 206, it prevents it from overboosting. So you can't harm the engine.
No over-temping, no over-torquing.
That's right, yeah.
Look at this.
Oh, this is beautiful.
This is pretty amazing.
Lots of view. Heaven's Landing traffic. Stationer 249 Tango Alpha is on a right cross from runway 5. Heaven's Landing.
Yeah, flying around the mountains is a really fun time, in my opinion. You can't beat the scenery.
That's
I know, though, a lot of people are out west are going to say these are mountains, but...
so is Florida people.
That's right.
When you live in Florida, these are mountains.
Take a week to get.
That's where I'm from. And right down there is Clayton. That'd be Clayton right down there, right?
That's right. Yeah, should be.
How is it back there, Captain Mindy?
It's nice. I don't know last time I sat back here, but I have a ton of room. It's nice to be chauffeured around. It's really nice. That's what happens when you win tournaments.
Yeah, Mindy and Sarah, they get to fly these 206s all the time, so they're letting me have a little fun today. So we took off VFR. We're going to pick up our IFR in the air.
And heading with landing traffic, stationer 249 Tango Alpha, supporting the area out to the south. Thanks for a good time.
And when you're flying VFR, you got to keep your cloud clearances in mind to remain within visual flight rules.
Good morning, Atlanta Center. Stationer 249 Tango Alpha, 4900. Just departed Heaven's Landing, looking for an IFR clearance to Falcon Field.
Number 249er Tango Alpha, squawk 5267.
5267, Niner Tango Alpha.
Nice thing with the 206, you can leave the power full forward all the way up till
number one hotel
your climb.
It'll be
awesome.
Frequency on departure.
Aren't any restrictions that I have to power back or anything?
We checked on with ATC, now we're just waiting back for him to get radar contact with us and spot us on his radar.
Number 714 Tango Sierra, you checking in.
And then he'll come back with our position and altitude and give us our clearance.
Number 249er Tango Alpha, radar contact 20 miles southeast of Harris. Say altitude, gains altimeter 3025.
3025, 6,800, climbing for 8,000 for Niner Tango Alpha.
Niner Tango Alpha, roger, cleared to Falcon Field via direct, climb maintain 8,000.
Falcon Field via direct, 8,000, Niner Tango Alpha.
How about that? I like that. That's an easy clearance there.
I would say so.
There's 1,000 to go, 7,000 for 8,000.
2609 Atlanta Center.
And we've been given a clearance direct to our destination. See if that holds up all the way. I have a feeling we're going to get some different reroutes here soon. Here, we'll put the autopilot on. Mindy, what headset are you wearing back there? I didn't watch. Oh, yeah, you got the new Bose on too?
Yeah, I have the new ProFlights on.
How do you think it handles the noise levels of the 206?
Oh, significantly better than what I thought it was going to. I think it's a comfortable noise. Like, it's not as good as the A20, but it's definitely not loud.
Yeah, I think it handles it pretty well. You can see on our monitor, we do have a few showers and storms off there at our 2 or 3 o'clock. That'll be no factor for us. What kind of fuel burn will you get at about 8,000 feet with this airplane?
So the fuel burn with the Turbo 206, since it is a turbo, you're going to see a consistent about 19.2 gallons an hour on the airplane. It's because it's turbocharged.
Okay.
It always thinks it's at sea level, that's why.
We got an ETE 39 minutes, so we're within coffee time. Coffee time is usually 1 hour to destination when it's safe to drink your beverages, so we're good there. Beautiful day to be flying some airplanes. If you guys are thinking about becoming a pilot, be sure to check out my friend Jason Shepard, M0A.com. He also has a YouTube channel. His online flight training prep, and he's a lot of different cool videos of different procedures of becoming a pilot training.
Tango Alpha, I have a flight amendment to your route, advise and ready to copy.
There we go.
Ready to copy, Niner Tango Alpha.
Number 9 or Tango Alpha, clear to Falcon Field via direct WOMAC. It's Whiskey, Oscar, Mike, Alpha, Charlie, direct.
Alright, WOMAC direct destination, 9 or Tango Alpha.
Oh, there's the reroute that we
knew it was coming.
Suspecting. If you take a look down here at 4 Flight, this is our route today after we got a reroute. You can see I got Atlanta's airspace up ahead. We got our one intersection WOMAC and then direct to Falcon Field. This will be my second landing ever in a station. The first one I came in with about a 5-knot tailwind due to the way the runways are laid out with the mountains. I thought it landed pretty good considering a slight tailwind, narrow runway, and a lot of different elevation changes in the runway. I feel like I did a pretty good job with how the airplane handled it. I thought it's a pretty forgiving airplane to land.
Yeah, you landed it really well.
I think that's all thanks to the airplane, being forgiving.
And you're a great coach.
Yeah, that's true. Mindy was coaching me on that one.
I don't know. I think this second landing is going to be even better. I think so, too.
No pressure, but I do have two professionals with me here today. We'll see how my second landing today goes.
Niner Tango Alpha, contact on approach 132.47.
132.47, have a good one, Niner Tango Alpha. Good morning, Atlanta Approach, stationary 249, Tango Alpha, 8000.
249, Tango Alpha, Atlanta Approach, the path is altimeter 3019, just going to maintain 6000.
3019, 6000, Niner Tango Alpha.
All right, we put 6000 in our altitude selector, and we'll VS down.
Yep, perfect.
About 500 feet a minute.
That works for me.
One thing I like about this airplane, too, is, you know, when it's hot outside, you got the air conditioning installed in this plane.
Yeah.
So what do you have it set to over there?
It's set down to 59 right now.
59 degrees.
November 1,
nice and cool.
Niner, Niner. November 9, Tango Alpha, flighting 240.
240, Niner Tango Alpha.
Okay, so we're going to go into heading mode, and then we'll switch our heading book to 240. And autopilot will turn us over to that direction.
Yeah, I think we're going to get over Hartsfield again.
Mindy's good luck. When you fly with her up here, you get right over the airport all the time.
We're getting the special Mindy treatment.
I guess they all know her up here somehow.
Somehow.
249 Tango Alpha, contact approach 126.97.
126.97, 249 Tango Alpha.
CBM 31 Romeo Mike, radar contact.
A lot of different boats and all the different dots.
340 on the heading, 31 Romeo Mike.
Good morning, Atlanta Approach, stationary 249 Tango Alpha, 6000.
Stationer 249, Tango Alpha, Atlanta Approach, good afternoon. Altimeter 3021, expect vectors for Falcon Field for the visual approach this afternoon.
We'll expect vectors for the visual, Niner Tango Alpha.
Good job on the radio, sir. Hey, we're getting vectored around. Really great view of downtown Atlanta over here.
Zero copies, radar vectors.
And right next to it.
And then as well.
Correct.
There's that rain.
And as usual, look at there's bad traffic.
Yeah. Right on cue.
We got a little rain shower off to our left here.
Looking fine, following standby, get back to you.
ETC's been giving us a good job. We cut the cameras off, but they've been doing a good job. We just turned them back on, of vectoring us around the different clouds and storms. So thanks to Atlanta Controllers.
16, you're now about 4 miles.
They're doing a good job.
Here's the Georgia Aquarium. Have you been there before?
Here's the Georgia Aquarium.
Right there with the big G fish on it to the left.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Do you see it?
Yeah. No, I've never been there.
They have whale sharks in there. It's pretty cool.
That's like the biggest shark ever, right?
Yeah.
Oh, and you got the Mercedes-Benz. Look at that. You're not going to see it in the cameras, but right over the Mercedes-Benz stadium.
Right over it.
We're going to probably have a little bit of a bumpy ride going through these little clouds, so hope everybody at home's got their seatbelts tight. Right now we're IMC, which is amazing. We cannot see out the windows. We're relying off our instruments. Getting your IFR rating is a really fun experience, in my opinion. I think flying gets a lot more fun when you get to do different approaches and fly through the clouds.
Definitely.
Or just flying VFR.
You can fly so much more, too.
Exactly, you're not limited.
Yeah, you don't get stuck on the ground.
Number 9 or Tango Alpha, turn 10 degrees left.
10 left, 9 or Tango Alpha.
And there's Atlanta Hartsfield right out here in front of us. And right over the top of it. That's actually the safest spot to be, is right over the top, you know, with all the different arrivals and departures.
Don't have to worry about wake turbulence.
Yeah, this spot right here is the best spot to go.
And there's the Porsche track. See right there, that red tag?
Okay. Oh, that's for Porsche?
Uh-huh. They have like a driving experience there where you drive Porsches on that racetrack.
Oh, that's going to be fun.
Yeah.
Have you ever done that?
I haven't. I'd like to. It looks pretty neat.
About 2 southwest W indicating 2.
Yeah, I can actually see a port, one of the cars going around it right now.
Yeah, see them on the tag.
Porsche on 816, we're looking at the TCAS.
You want to set up the visual approach into 3-1?
Yeah, let's do that. Yep. So we're going to be expecting 3-1.
We'll just load the visual in.
Taking a straight in visual approach with the NXI technology. That's right, that's what technology is giving us.
Yeah, that's with the new NXI, that you can load visual approaches. If they're the airport's in the G1000 database, it builds an approach, a visual approach.
For guidance.
Every airport, yeah. It helps with situational awareness, especially when you're going into unfamiliar strips. It's really helpful.
Procedure Padgett when you're able.
How has your in-flight experience been so far, Mindy?
I didn't get my snacks or beverages, but
what about
you can work on that for next time.
What about your cap? What about Captain Stevo? Has he been doing an amazing job?
We'll talk after your landing.
Oh, God. You're right, the landing. Everybody judges the pilot because of their landing.
Uh-huh. It's the only thing that people remember.
Yep. Falcon Field is an uncontrolled airfield, so we'll be going over to a UNICOM frequency once we get finished with Atlanta. We'll basically plan to enter over midfield and then into a left downwind for 3-1.
Tango Whiskey, thank you. Number 249 or Tango Alpha, proceed direct Falcon Field, I'll lower shortly.
direct Falcon, Niner Tango Alpha.
Number 249 or Tango Alpha, descend and maintain 3000, advise me of Falcon Field in sight.
3000, Niner Tango Alpha, we'll let you know.
To get down again.
Dragon 50, traffic no factor, climb and maintain 9000.
All right, we're going to 3000 out of vacating 5000. We'll start to look out the window here to get the airport in sight.
And Atlanta approach, 249 Tango Alpha has the airport in sight. We can cancel now.
249 Tango Alpha, Roger, do show one in the pattern. Our for cancellation is received. Squawk VFR and have a good day.
Have a good one, Niner Tango Alpha. Falcon Field traffic, station R 249 Tango Alpha is 4.5 miles to the northeast. Going to overfly to join a left downwind 431 Falcon.
I'm going to actually take the autopilot off, if you don't mind, Sarah.
Go for it.
And have a little fun hand flying. All right, this is Falcon Field right here in front of us. Airport will be landing at. All right, I see down there, there's a guy pulling out on the runway for takeoff.
Okay. So we're just going to be looking for about 90 knots on our downwind. And once we turn down, we're out our first notch of flaps.
Okay.
About 80, 85 on our base leg. And then we're looking for about 70 knots on final and about 65 over the numbers. And we'll just pull the power back. And then as we're doing that, just roll back on the trim there. That should settle in for you.
Sounds good. There, it looks like another guy taxiing for takeoff down there. All right, we'll start our left turn for our left downwind.
Falcon traffic, stationary 249 Tango Alpha, making a left downwind for runway 31, Falcon.
Cartersville traffic, Skyhawk.
View of the runway.
61 is over midfield at 3,200 feet, transitioning to the southeast, Cartersville.
All right, I'm going to put in your first notch flaps here. We're below 140.
Sounds good. First notch selected and indicating. All right, we'll start our left base.
Falcon traffic, stationer 249 Tango Alpha is turning left base, 31, Falcon.
Clear to the left.
All right, we're clear on final.
And we'll turn our final approach.
I'm gonna bring those flaps in now.
And Falcon traffic, stationer 249 Tango Alpha, turning final, 31.
Everything's forward, our lights are on.
Looking good, all lined up.
Yep, now we're just gonna be looking for about 70 knots here, and then like I said, 5 over the numbers.
Sounds good.
Looking good.
The fuel we'll be using is over to the right there.
Yep, and if you keep that green dot on the end of the runway, you'll end up there.
That's pretty handy.
Yeah, airspeed's looking good. Alright, start pulling back on the power, and then bring that trim in, just let it settle in, pull the power out, yep, let it settle, oh,
oh
yeah.
Oh, that was way better than my first one.
Oh, yeah. That was a good one.
I'm so used to having reverse thrust.
We don't have that option on the 206.
Actually, look at the windsock too, it's a little bit light, variable tailwind on that again.
Yeah, you did pretty good.
I don't know, every landing I've had in this thing has been with tailwinds. Well, welcome to Falcon Field, guys. Hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. Also subscribe to the channel. I also link Sarah and Captain Mindy's Instagrams. So if you want to follow them on Instagram, be sure to click below. Everybody's doing good, and we'll talk to you again someday soon. You and me now. Living a quiet life. You and me now. We've been burned once or twice. I say, ooh, come a little closer. I say, ooh. It's gonna be out.